So in coming few slides, I will take you through Hindi and Bengali film posters, and we will see the role of typography in both of these posters. Content are structured in this way: introduction, methodology. We will be discussing about letter form structure and its meaning, property, expressive typography in title design, and is conclude with reference. The purpose of study is basically looking at film posters from two perspectives. One is pan-Indian culture, where with release of each Hindi film, film posters are distributed across the country and even across the world, cutting different group of people classified on the different social and economical basis and cultural background. And second one is a local context dealing with Bengali film posters, which are intended to deal with a specific segment of people having same cultural backgrounds. From the beginning of Indian cinema, different tools has been adopted by these both of the industry to advertise and publicize their films. During the early period, print media dominates the mode of publicity, and because of this, we can find a lot of booklet of film songs, stories, lobby cards, handbills, and of course posters, where posters become the most significant and dominating form. Both in Bengali and Hindi film posters, it features two parts. One is visual and another is textual. And textual content can be again classified featuring the leading character's name, film title, credit blocks, and sometimes taglines. Before going for the detailed discussion about the both film poster, we should just look at the nature of film produced by this both industry. When we talk about the Hindi film posters, and of course for the people who came from the different country, I would mention like Bollywood is defined by the Hindi film posters industry based in Bombay, and Tollywood is an industry of Bengali film poster which is based in Calcutta. So when we will look at a film poster, especially Hindi film poster, most of the films are melodramatic natures, full of actions, romance, social fictions and family plots. And this provides a multi-genre perspective, making it difficult to place it in a single category. This multi-genre film provide a lot of challenges to film title designers as well, whereas in other hands, the film belongs, film from the Bengali film industry, it belongs to, falls under the culture, it falls under parallel cinema, which is defined by its serious nature, realism and naturalism. So coming at the Hindi film posters, obvious from the title, Hindi film poster are publicity material for the Hindi movie, which is produced in the Bollywood, and which is also a biggest industry in the country and across the world. This poster tends to have started long back in 1913, when first its silent Hindi film was produced by Dada Saheb Phalke, which is Raja Harishchandra. There are some posters from beginning to like the famous film posters you can see. Poster has gone through significant changes over the time with the influence of the Western culture and technology. In terms of Hindi cinema, cultural and social diversity throughout the country gives an idea to distributors to divide the audience in different segments. One is big metro cities like Bombay, Delhi, Chennai, Kolkata, and second one is like the smaller towns and interiors. And third segment scatter the films of low budget, also the semi-porn film. So this way, the distributors have categorized this film so that it will be easier for them to advertise it and market it easily. This led to designing of different posters for each sector, keeping in mind their taste and desire, which ultimately leads a designer to play with the design elements of the poster. These are again some posters from Bollywood. You can see the different title, style, and the way it has been represented to reflect the theme of the films. When we came to the Bengali film posters, history goes back to 1919, just 6 years after the Hindi film posters. This industry has been marked by famous directors like Satyajit Ray, which is a well-renowned person in the parallel cinema, Minal Sen, Bimal Roy, Ritvik Ghatak. Title design in early period was considered as one of the important features of the film posters, and very artistic and expressive letter forms in the calligraphic strokes were popular. It is interesting to see that title design in most of the Satyajit Ray posters were done by him only. This shows the sensitivity and importance of the title design in the film posters. These are some film posters from Bengali cinema. In case of Bengali film posters, designer has to deal with the people of single segments, providing an ease for the poster design. They have more freedom to explore with the title, with the typeface. And again, Kolkata is famous for its unconventional street art. Still today, if you will visit Kolkata, you can see a lot of posters on the street, along with the multinational posters like the global posters from multinational company. Till today, when a lot of restrictions has been made regarding the billboards and signboards, placement in the public area street culture is following the same conventional parameters. We can't neglect the effect of globalization on the film posters. Globalization has major effect on the cultural transformation in India. Economic upgradation, social and political changes are the major force behind it. The exchange of ideas between the people of different cultures is evident since the long period. As a dominant medium of film publicity, poster has seen radical transformations by the influence of new technology and the proliferation of the visual culture in 20th century. Similar effect can be seen in the title design, and this new technological advancement and upgradation of design education provide an opportunity to designer to explore title design more a bit in form of style, texture, color, composition, and even expressive typography. You can here you can see the first one is the Hollywood film poster, and the similar effect has been adapted in the Hindi film poster, which is Kahin Din Kahin Raat, 1967. So the influence has been taken from the other film industry also. This is a snap I have given, like in this era there are a lot of billboards and then advertisement elements. So you can see this is a theater featuring a film, and on the more prominent part is the Lux Cozy innerwear advertisement. So this kind of culture where poster has to cope with all the parameters and the other things. For methodology, poster collection, these are the steps has been taken out: title analysis using semiotic approach, interpretation, and then conclusion. Basically, I have taken the Barthian visual semiotic approach, which is denotation, and it's talk about the layering of meaning, and one layer is denotation and another is connotation. The key idea behind is visual semiotics is layering of meaning. The first layer is the layer of denotation, which deal with the who and what is being represented, where the second layer is the layer of connotation, which inquires about the value and idea expressed through what is represented and through the way in which it is represented. The same approach has been used to analyze the layer of meaning given by the letter forms in the film, in this film titling. It will be significant to discuss the Saussurean dyadic model again, which states that sign is a whole which results from the association of signifier and signified. The relationship between these two is known as signification, and whole meaning evolved because of this relationship and sign within the systems. So these two approaches has been adopted. Now looking at the letter forms and individual letter forms and its characters. Individual letters act as a building block of the title design when where it forms and dimension play an important role in communication of the film theme. Looking from the Barthes visual semantic point of view, the denotation of individual letter is an unproblematic issue. Knowing the written language ensures each viewer to read and understand the literal meaning of the title. But the constructive meaning of the title gets generated through the understanding of message, which is hidden somewhere in the style and structure of the font. This could be further understood by these two examples. One is the historical Razia Sultan film. It came in 1983, and another is family drama, which is Hum Saath Saath Hain, 1999. For Hum Saath Saath Hain, readers are encouraged to understand the phrase and relate it with the family structure in the Indian society, whereas in Razia Sultan, along with the name, a symbolic meaning has been represented to the viewer based on the context of time, popularity and strength of the main character of the film. Here, individual letters has been designed and arranged in such a way that it looks like entrance of a fort and present a feel of Sultan. Looking at the pan-Indian culture before designing the Bollywood film poster, designer would look at two parameters. First one is our posters are made for different cultural segments, catering different group of people across the country. And second one is the most of the Bollywood films belongs to multi-genre. So it's very difficult for a designer to design a poster, a title, which can cater so many cultural diversity in India. And this provides some constraints to designer. One is the poster is going to be distributed all over the world, all over the India, irrespective of the regional languages. And another is because of limitation of technology and fading of vernacular approach. Vernacular approach means where initially it was the hand painted and individually crafted, but now it's a digital technology has taken part of it. These are some timeline. When in the beginning in the film posters, the minimum exploration has been done, like font were very plain, monocolor, and less explored. And here you can see in the below pictures, in the beginning when the hand painting style was dominant, we can see a different counter spaces in the similar letters across the title in a single title. So, but this is the beauty of that period. When we analyze individual letter and title design of Hindi film poster across the timeline, we can see that there are very least variation in the letter form. The variations are mainly in the term of orientation, perspective and thickness of the font. Here I have taken letter A and just analyze it, the change in the form or structure of the letter A. The variation is in the term of orientation, perspective and thickness of the font. The variation in the individual font in a title can be noticed in terms of stroke thickness, size and counter space in the poster up to 70s. There might be one strong reason behind this. Variation is all posters till 1970s were hand painted and artists designed the title manually, and in the most of the cases without using grid. The three-dimensional lettering style dominated the title design during 1950s to till 1980s. And some of the exact examples which is not here are the Mughli Azam.
Excuse me, I have to just remind you of the time. Thank you.
So this kind of transition you can see. In contrast to Bollywood, in cinema where posters were designed to cater different culture, Tollywood film posters are centered to one specific cultures. And this would probably provide a huge opportunity for experimentation and exploration with the Bengali letters. And also we can see the influence from the Shantiniketan, because the industry is flourished with the designer which are highly design sensitive and got education from Shantiniketan. These are the letters where letter ka and ba and then na has been analyzed, and we can see in this slide like the variations were explored a lot in the term of the Bengali film poster, where a typical letter has been transformed in a like an abstract form. In letter ka we can see a Hindi ka like, and then it has been modified in a different way. Whereas in the Hindi film poster titled like letter A, though we can see some of the semiotic approach like the disco dancer, A taken from the film Disco Dancer, the effect. So this way, coming to expressive typography, it is used to express idea, style, emotion in form of the convenient way. Till 1960s, the Hindi film poster witnessed very little exploration in terms of use of external typography. By the end of 60s and early 70s, artists have started to explore with the typography. You can see like the Angur, you can feel of like it. Another is Singh Dwar, it's a Bengali film poster. And we can see a lot of expressive typography in Bengali film poster. You can look at the title and you can relate it with the story or the theme of the film. These are some more examples from the both industry and some of the explicit typography. So need more time to discuss and analyze. So these are the conclusions. Title design has a significant role, though all we know. In the beginning, the variations are very minimal, but the advancement in technology and upgrades of design knowledge enhance the possibility of exploration. We can relate it, we can see the local context has given a more opportunity to explore instead of the coming to the national or the pan-Indian culture context where we have to deal with the different culture of peoples. Technology has played a huge role in mass production of the posters and opened up the opportunity for more exploration in the form of color textures, but it has limited the skill of the creativity. These are my references. Thank you so much. Okay, thank you.